How to calculate cash from operating activities, or CFOA, using the direct method. Let me explain to you how to construct a cash flow statement in this short video. This video covers the direct method of cash flow reporting. The companion video that I will link to in the description below covers the indirect method. Start off with reviewing the inputs to your assignment. What I am showing here are the inputs that I gave to participants in one of my Finance for Non-Financial Manager courses, to have them construct the income statement, balance sheet and cash flow statement for year 2 of an exercise. So we started off with the year 1 financial statements, and with this list of inputs they constructed year 2 financial statements. In this video we focus on the cash flow statement and we use the direct method to construct it. What happens to the company in year 2? Revenue doubles, gross profit percentage stays the same, headcount increases by 50% at same average salary, collections of receivables equals new invoices issued, purchases of chocolate from supplier 250, payments to supplier 200, no new investments in P&E, debt level, the amount borrowed from the bank, is unchanged, no new equity issued. In order to transfer these inputs into numbers, let's construct a year 2 income statement, and then we will select the relevant items from there to help build the cash flow statement. On the left is the prior year, year 1, income statement, and each of the inputs from the prior page helps you to construct the current year, year 2, income statement on the right. If revenue doubles, then it goes from 200 to 400. If gross profit as percentage of revenue stays the same, then cost of sales goes to 200 and gross profit goes to 200. Headcount increases by 50% at the same average salary, so it goes from 20 to 30. No new investments in P&E, and using the same depreciation schedule keeps depreciation at 20. EBIT goes from 60 to 150 due to operating leverage. The interest amount stays the same if the debt level and the interest rate are unchanged. And taxes go up proportionally if profit before tax goes up. 20% of 140 is 28. Now, which ones of these items are important for us if we want to construct the cash flow statement using the direct method? Revenue is important, and we saw in the inputs that collections of receivables equals new invoices issued. Note that in real life, this is very rarely the case. In this example, cash received from customers in year 2 is therefore 400. Cost of sales is interesting, but it does not directly give us the amount of cash payments to suppliers. Cost of sales may be higher or lower than that, due to inventory and or payables increasing or decreasing. On the previous page, we saw that payments to suppliers are 200, so by accident, these are equal to cost of sales. Once again, in real life, this is very rarely the case. Cash paid to employees often equals the total compensation and benefits booked in the P&L. Employees get paid in the month in which they work. Unless you record expenses for bonuses and commissions that you accrue for this year, but only pay next year. Interest paid usually equals the amount of interest booked in the P&L. Income taxes paid, in real life, rarely equals the amount of income taxes booked in the P&L, but in this example it does, to keep things simple. Let's summarize the items we have found so far. In the direct method of cash flow reporting, you start off with cash received from customers of 400, you deduct cash paid to suppliers, 200, you deduct cash paid to employees, 30, interest paid, 10, and income taxes paid, 28. Total net cash provided by operating activities, calculated using the direct method, is 132, which should be the same if you calculate it by using the indirect method, which would reconcile from net income to CFOA by adjusting for non-cash items in the P&L plus changes in working capital. To complete this example and build the full cash flow statement, let's look for any clues on the lines of cash from investing activities, CFIA, and cash from financing activities, CFFA. In this example, to keep it simple, nothing is happening in either of those lines. In real life, for a mature and successful company, there would probably be a CapEx cash outflow in CFIA and a dividend cash outflow in CFFA. If you add up the three categories, cash from operating activities, cash from investing activities, and cash from financing activities, you get to the net increase or decrease in cash. Please note that you have not yet completed the full cash flow statement. An important step is to check on the balance sheet what the amounts were of the opening cash balance and the closing cash balance. Opening cash was 60, closing cash was 192. The net increase or decrease in cash that you calculated should be the difference between those two balances. The last step in constructing your cash flow statement is to show just that. The net increase in cash of 132 plus the opening cash of 60 equals the closing cash balance of 192. Done. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this example of how to construct a cash flow statement, then please press the like button for me and share it with friends and colleagues. On this end screen, there are a few suggestions of videos you can watch next. Please subscribe to the Finance Storyteller channel and stay up to date on new videos. Thank you.